Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another review here at Frag Nation. Today, we are going to be looking at the TT Esports Poseidon Z Forged Mechanical Keyboard. Man, that's a mouthful. Before we get into it, I just want to first kind of apologize to you guys, the audience, and the guys over at TT Esports as well for the delay in this video. Many of you know I was in an automobile accident a couple months ago, and I literally just got cleared 2 months later. So it's been a long stretch. I haven't really been able to do anything, and I'm really, really happy and excited to finally get back in here and tell you guys what I think about this keyboard. So don't go anywhere. We'll be right back on Frag Nation TV. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, here we have the Poseidon Forged Z keyboard. Now, let's just start off by saying I use a SteelSeries Apex Raw. Well, actually, I use the regular Apex, but I had a Raw as well. And when I got this keyboard, I was excited to review something from TT Esports. However, I was really skeptical having to replace my everyday use of the SteelSeries Apex or the SteelSeries Raw, whatever, with this. And to my surprise, this thing is my favorite keyboard in the world. And I have not used the Apex since I received this. Usually what I do with review copies and review items is once I'm done, I give them away. This is going to be my everyday keyboard, and let's talk about why. So the first thing, when I saw this keyboard, I was like, cool, it's got a hand rest, that's great. This is good. It comes off if I don't want it. That's awesome. The built-in hand rests on the Apex and stuff really kind of get on my nerves after a while. Sometimes I like it like this, sometimes I don't. The next thing is, when I saw that, I was like, okay, that's great. What am I gonna do about all the USB ports? This thing has two USB ports right here, and additionally, it has a headset jack and a microphone jack right here. That is amazing. I love that. It was really nice to have that built in there. The next thing I thought, okay, my SteelSeries Apex is very durable. It's a really durable keyboard. This thing is literally like almost all metal. Like this strip is metal. This platform here is all metal. It's heavy, it's got weight to it, but it's not, you know, overbearingly heavy. You can still pick it up with one hand with ease and do what you need to do. And it's very, very durable. I love it, okay? The keys themselves, I believe, are the blue switch, so nice, good tactile response on everything. Nice spacing, staggered rows. They have media keys built in here as well. The one thing that I was thinking that I might not like is it has an FN key here instead of the app data key, which I don't know really who uses an app data key anymore anyways, but when you're looking at this, I was like, damn, oh wait, my left window, or my right windows is still here. That's amazing. I have right and left windows, still have my FN key. That's how you adjust the media settings and the illumination for the keyboard. That would be the one thing that I don't normally like right now, is I didn't like the illumination settings being on the keyboard. I like a third-party program to control that. I would have liked a little more customization on this particular keyboard. They do make one called the RGB, I believe. It's the same type of keyboard, but with lots of illumination settings. I wish they would have given us a little bit of something like that with this. All right, the next thing that we want to talk about are the flip-ups. You have two flip-up pads here. Doesn't give you a whole lot of depth. Sometimes I like the keyboards to have two settings, this one and then one maybe back here that lifts up above that for some better lean. That doesn't give you too much lean. The keyboard itself is slanted anyways. We'll look at it from this side profile. You can see here that it's got a kind of natural curve to it anyways. So when you attach the hand rest, it feels really good. It's nice, it's natural. One other thing I didn't like about the keyboard was this space bar. The space bar is It's a little short, I feel. I'm used to that big fat space bar that you have with the Apex and the Apex Raw. This right here feels a little weird. My thumb just kind of slips off a little bit when I'm at my WASD. I would have maybe liked it to be a little bit bigger. And you can see there where my hand rests naturally and then where I have to put it to be able to strike that key. Now, the response on this keyboard is amazing. It's, like I said, very tactile, very good. You have your MX keys or ghosting keys here, so you can set up bindings. You have a set here as well. So you have, 10 different options for keys here. You have illumination on these keys, all these keys. Now, the reason I'm pointing this out is because originally, when I got this keyboard, I thought it was broken. And I thought it was broken because the F12 key does not light up until you hit the FN key and the F12 key to activate whatever mode or whatever that does, as well as the same thing happens for a couple other keys. The caps lock key, for instance, I thought was broken, but it just is toggles on and off when you press the caps lock key, so you can tell whether it's on or off, which makes sense, but without an explanation or something like that, people might think they have defective keys. Really, this keyboard has outlived it and outsurpassed the expectations that I thought going into something like TT Esports. They're new on the block, but they're made by Thermaltake. Thermaltake is a very great PC company. They make a lot of great PC products, and they nailed it with this. One other complaint I had was the use of this escape key. It's in a weird, it needs to be here. Move it over, put it there. When you put this extra row of keys here, it feels weird when I'm searching for my escape key and I can't tell if this is the F1 key, because that's where the F1 key should be, and then here's my escape key here. It's just, if it was like just this part, that would be fine, but when you add this, maybe offset that, I don't know, that's just a suggestion, just a little complaint that I had. Now, something that I liked was, as you can see, there's no wire. And that's because it's here. It is a detachable USB cable, and it's braided. Thank God it's braided. Good job, TT Esports, for making braided cables. Nice, thick plastic here. That gives you a really good, sturdy connection. Doesn't feel like it's gonna break, no fraying, and I'm an advocate for braided cables for everything. This thing attaches right here in the back. Really simple, just plug right in and you can unplug it. Now, the last thing that I want to talk about is probably the biggest concern that I have with the keyboard, and that's occasionally I lose connectivity and the keyboard will stay on. So it'll be connected to the PC, the keyboard will be on and lit, but when I press keys, nothing will happen. I have to unplug it and plug it back in and it works fine. And that happens with the USB ports as well. Probably driver issues, that's what I'm assuming. So maybe that's fixed in an upcoming driver update. We'll have to check on that. So overall, do I recommend the TT Esports Poseidon Z Forged keyboard? Yes, you need to buy this, and you need to buy it right now, because you will love this keyboard. It's not very expensive. It's mechanical. It's heavy. It's durable. It sounds amazing. It looks amazing. And we're going to show you some pictures of that here at the end of the keyboard all lit up. Guys, go check them out. TT Esports right there for your keyboard needs. This right here is a highly recommended keyboard. You have to get this if you are looking for something for this holiday season and you're looking for an affordable keyboard that a gamer is gonna love, or maybe that you'll love for a gift to yourself. You need to pick this keyboard up. Thank you guys so much for watching, and we will see you next time on Frag Nation TV.